Yes, I was doing on the page number 10, the fourth question. The question was which continents are spread in all the four hemispheres? I think we discussed about Africa, the continent of Africa. Which is there in all the four hemispheres? Now, when we study about it, if I take Australia, where it lies? It lies in the south, southern hemisphere, yes, right, and in the eastern hemisphere. If I take the continent of North America, where it lies? It lies in the western hemisphere, and the name itself, it says it is in the northern hemisphere. South America, if I take the South America lies in the continent of South America lies, a part of it, which lies in the northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere. Yes, we are right. And it lies in the western hemisphere. The Europe, the major part of the Europe lies in the eastern hemisphere and it is in the northern hemisphere. The continent of Asia lies in the northeastern hemisphere. The continent of Africa was our answer. It lies in the northern hemisphere, a small tip, which is adjacent to the Mediterranean Sea, the southern hemisphere, eastern hemisphere, and western hemisphere. The last question over here, at which two parallels do all the meridians converge? Converge means which all two parallels, these two meridians converge. This I have already told you, this is the North Pole and this is the South Pole. At these two points, all the meridians converge at 90 degrees north and 90 degrees south. The meridians converge at 90 degrees north and 90 degrees south. Now, the next is, when we talk about various places, what we tell about, we always refer to the location of the place. The location which is being expressed with the help of the parallels of latitudes and the meridians of longitude. Now, when we talk about the location of the place, it's very important for us to identify. For example, if I look at the map and I'll open the map. Can we have the map of India in front of us? That's at least we know many of the things of India. Yes. If I got the map of India in front of you, if you have the atlas at home, you can refer. Here we have got the latitudinal and the longitudinal extent. Now when we see about the latitudinal and longitudinal extent, we see that these are the vertical lines are longitude and these horizontal lines are latitudes. Let us check whether all the maps have the latitudinal and longitudinal extent. Yes, I am here in the Bihar and Jharkhand map. It also has latitudes and longitudes. Here it is not shown the latitudes and longitudes, but here it is not shown the smaller map in which the latitudes and longitudes are not shown on the map because it is not required. The purpose is different of showing the map. When I am using about this physical map, or the map of North Korea and South Korea, China, Mongolia, it also shows the latitudes and longitude. So to express any place or location of any place, we refer to the latitudinal and the longitudinal location of the place. When I am talking about Pune, we see that Pune is located at 18 degrees 51 minutes. Minutes is the smaller part of the degree, is called as a minute. So 18 degrees 51 minutes north latitude and 73 degrees and 85 minutes east longitude. It is one single point because we are describing only one small city. The state of Maharashtra is also roughly, I have written about, it extends about 90 degrees to 7 degrees 75 minutes in north to 75 degrees. 71 minutes east is the location of Maharashtra. Suppose I have a map of India. I want to find out the location of Maharashtra. All of you have the map of India. If you have, you can refer. In the map of India, see, Maharashtra is so small, but still we say it is very large state. It extend, this is the area wise, the largest, not largest state, this is the state of Maharashtra. Whereas we know that the Rajasthan is the largest state, and we know the small state Goa, which is the south of Maharashtra, is the smallest state in India. So we have to take a reference. We are talking about any city or a village or a particular place. We give only one single coordinate. We are using the word coordinates where the latitudes and the longitudes which are being reflected. We talk all that as an the coordinates of the place. Whereas the region or a country. For example, when I am giving you the example about the equatorial region, I say it extends from 10 degrees north to 10 degrees south is an equatorial region. So where is the 10 degrees north and 10 degrees south? If it is there on the globe, you can see that this is the 0 degrees and this is 10 degrees north, 10 degrees south. The places lie in between these is called as an experiences an equatorial climate. The places which lies above 25 degrees or above 30 degrees latitude, we call them as an, they are the temperate countries of the world. The places which lies between 10 degrees to 30 degrees or 25 degrees, it is called the tropical countries of the world. And above that, subtropical countries. Then we have a temperate country. Then we have a polar region. This is how the world is being divided with the different types of latitudinal location. Now when I am giving a region or a country, I have to give between what is the extent? So it is 10 degrees to 12 degrees north and 15 degrees to 20 degrees is the south, is the location of the place, and therefore it has the length and the breadth. And therefore we have to give two coordinates of the place. What is the extent from one place to another place is the extent of the place we see, and the north, south and the east, west extent of the state or a region we have to divide or we have to decide. And when we are explaining the place for any region in detail, the third important point which we have to describe the location, we have to, what we say about the linear feature on the, what is the linear feature? Anything which goes straight, we call it as a linear. What we have the linear? We have a mountain range in the linear. For example, Western Ghats, they are linear, they run in the north-south direction. Kalsubai is the highest peak in Maharashtra. As we go towards the south, the height of the mountains increases and they are called as a linear arrangement of the mountains. Whereas the roads which run, they are the linear roads or the rivers which are running as the linear locations or the linear coordinates. When we have to give the linear location, I have to give the source region from where it is being originating and where it is ending. I have to give the two different coordinates from the source to the mouth of the river. From the river, the road which originates to the road which it meets. Suppose I am talking about river Ganges or the river, any of the river in the world. We have to give the extent from where it originates at the Gobok or Gangotri and it joins to the Bay of Bengal. So this is what the linear expansion of the road. The linear expansion, how much is the spread, how much is the length of the river is being explained, and therefore we have to have the origin, that is the source of the river and where it joins to the main sea or the ocean or whatever, wherever it is the end point, we call this river. In the similar way, we also have the different canals. You know the canals? The canals also have a breadth and a length. We have a Panama Canal, we have a Suez Canal. These are also important canals which are being used for the means of transportation. Therefore, the extent of the linear features are also explained with the help of two different coordinates from the origin and from the source of the region. Let us use the graticule and identify. Can you open? Am I clear to you, children? The graticules are very important. The graticules are the latitudes with the help of latitude and with the help of meridians of longitude. The location which is being expressed is called as a gratitude. The other important point which we have to discuss, the location and the extent. We don't say the location. When we are covering a region, what is the extent of the region? For example, we can say about India, it is extend from 6 degrees to 33 degrees northern hemisphere. India extends roughly about 8 degrees 4 minutes to 37 degrees 6 minutes in the north and 68 degrees. Can we see it on the map, on the globe, children? India extends from 8 degrees 4 minutes to 37 degrees 6 minutes in the north and 68 degrees to 97 degrees 25 minutes is the east, is the location. So it has the length and the breadth, and therefore we are having the two different latitudes and the two different longitudes. In the similar way, the location of any of the linear places of the river, we have to explain. Now in your book, they have given you a test. Test to identify. It's a very interesting place to do. A Brazil. We are learning Brazil. When you go to 10th standard, you will be learning more of Brazil. In the 10th standard, we are going to have a comparative analysis. So let us get acquainted. Anybody knows what is the famous of Brazil? Yes, we know that the Brazil is known for the football. You all love football, and it is the one of the football, the country where the football is the national game. Anyone knows the national game of India? Yes, you are right. It is hockey is the national game of India. Football is the national game of Brazil. The coffee production is done maximum in the Brazil. Brazil is one of the largest producer of coffee. India also produces coffee to a greater extent. And even the tea which is being produced. And therefore India and Brazil is being studied together to make a comparative analysis between in the 10th standard, which is a developed country or which is both are developing countries in the world. Now, in your book, just for your information, children, the Brazil, I thought you should be aware about the country. Knowing any country is always important. You know how who ruled the Brazil earlier? The Portuguese. They ruled the Brazil for a larger period of time. And therefore, the Spanish is the spoken language for the last number of people in Brazil. Which is the national language of India? Yes, it is Hindi. Which is the state language of Maharashtra? It is Marathi. Now, we talk, all of us, we talk all the mixed languages. We neither speak English fluently, we neither speak Hindi fluently or non-Marathi. We make the khichdi of all the languages. So make sure you have to, and we are in the global age. We have the different languages which are being used in the globally. English is being used globally. Okay. Let us come back to the page number 11. Let us use the gratitude.